Hi there. So here I have the T-Sun ceiling light, which is remote controlled, app controlled, and also has a built-in speaker, and this is RGB as well. Looks a bit like a giant flying saucer, as you can see here. You could throw this up and do some interesting fake UFO videos, but anyway, there we go. So the top just twists off, and that's the inside part there. And then we've got a connector to connect the speaker to the main board, which is this here. We've got live and neutral cables, and we've got like a rubber pot, rubber washer to thread the cable through. So I've got a cable to hand. So I'm not actually putting this up yet because I'm moving into a new house, and so I want to put it in there rather than sort of put it up in my current home. So I thought I'd just give this a run through. Now it is tricky getting this cable through the, actually getting it through the actual hole. It's a bit tight, but I could still sort of wire it up this way. It's not ideal, but at least get to see what it looks like. Obviously I can update some photos and things once I've got it up in my new house. Now what I'm going to use quickly are some special clips here, which means I can pop it together really easily. I'll have to rest around the wire. So we've got neutral clipped in there, and I've got neutral going into this side, which is in there, and I managed to get that round. And then we can do the live. I will just cap off the earth just from a safety perspective, but any issues with that, let's just cap this earth off. I prefer these type of clips. You can get thinner ones as well, which makes life so much easier when you're trying to wire stuff in. And of course we've got live. Come on, try and pop these open so I can put the wire in. Okay, so let's pop that in there. It's not going anywhere. And then we can put the other cable in there. Oh, I'm undone this. Put that in there. Okay, like that. And then sort of slightly tricky bit is we've got to connect this cable to this one, which as you can see is not ideal. It doesn't sort of black to black. I'm assuming we'll put it this way around then. Try and line up the coloured cables. So that's connected in, and then this just drops back on top there and twists and line the holes up. It does twist. Damage that cable. There we go, so that just twists on. In theory, I should be able to just plug this in and it'll work. That's the band. So we have light. So let me just turn the lights off here so you can see. It does look quite smart. It's got a very sort of glittery effect on this lid. And there we go. And so it's putting out a lot of light. Got the remote control here. Let's sort of turn it off. It's got batteries in, no it hasn't. We need 2x AAA's. I'm just going to go and grab those. Always have batteries to hand for doing reviews, because you never know which ones you're going to need. I pop a couple of AAA's in, and then we should be working. So we've got, well, that's warm, cool, and sort of can take it down to more a white light, you can see there, or we can take it up to a much warmer light. Let's take the brightness down a bit as well. The brightness doesn't seem to be going down particularly. There we go, hold it down a bit more and the brightness will go down. Now we also have RGB. Whoa, that's quite funky. That's actually changing colour by itself there. Oh, That's quite useful. Now you've got mode as well, so this is obviously scrolling slowly through the colours. And push mode. Blimey, it blinded me then, come on, so bright. I'm just pushing the mode button here to change this. Well, the mode just seems to switch the white colours. Let me go back to the white, different temperatures of white, I should say. Let's go back to a colour. So just pushing the RGB button. Different effects, as you can see. I do like the blue, looks quite impressive actually. As you see, you've got lots of different colours and tones and functions. Just put back to normal warm white. It's quite bright. Get that down a bit. Okay, now this does have an app as well. I'm just trying to see what does give you a code on this. So we've got to download an app which looks to be called ilink. So I've got my tablet to hand here, so let me go to the Play Store and we'll type in ilink and see what comes up. So I want ilink, there we go, install. So I'm installing the app at the moment, and it says Bluetooth connection. First of all, please change your phone sound, turn Bluetooth and pair with ilink. Enter the Bluetooth, discover ilink device, and then once you've done it, it connects automatically. And of course then it will, you can also play music through this. Now the instructions aren't extensive, as you can see. But we have got, when you use lamp first time, please enter the phone Bluetooth. Yeah, I get all that bit. Then there looks to be a music interface on the app. Okay, so iLinks while we're using the app. And then, okay, I'm just opening up the software. Okay, so I need to then pair the light with my. So I've got the ilink app, ilink. Okay, pair. So it looks like I'm paired. I just want to go back to the app and just see what I can do, if it is definitely paired. No, so that's not actually doing anything. So I'm not convinced I'm paired. No, that's not. Let's go to settings on here. Bluetooth connect. So it looks to be searching for the light. Now, does it say what I need to do here in terms of pair with iLink, enter the Bluetooth, discover and connect the device name iLink. Once connected, you'll hear the tone. Okay, so we're waiting to hear a tone. Now, I can't find, at this point in time, I can't seem to find the device, or say the device, the light. I Okay, well, we're not finding the light here at all, so I'm not sure. I'm going to go down to my Bluetooth settings again. I've got another ilink come up, so I'm going to click on that and see whether that needs to pair that as well. Ah, okay, so that noise means we're paired. Cool. So I should be able to go to the app. Let's go back. Okay, so I'm going to choose red. And nothing happens. Okay, that's not. Let's go Bluetooth connect. Try that again. Seems a little fiddly way round with this. You sort of need to pair with your Bluetooth on your device first, what I can gather. But it's not. You hear a tone. So I've heard a tone, but I'm not getting anything changing on. Change the brightness on the app. Turn it off, turn it on. So we're not paired here for some reason. I'm not quite sure. When I click on Bluetooth connect in the app, it says that once you open it, yeah, I've done that, open it, iLink app main interface, click the menu, enter BT connect, then enter BT connect, then click link to connect. Well, it's not finding anything to connect to. To be honest, we'll go back in there again. Bluetooth connect. So we're not connecting the app itself. Is the light is connected to my tablet, but the app isn't picking up the light, although it is connected to my tablet. I just want to check the Bluetooth settings again on there. So it is definitely connected. It's definitely connected there, I can see that. But I have, at the moment, I have no control over this light. And when I go into Bluetooth Connect on the app, so I'm gonna close the app down, and then let me close everything down, I've got so much stuff open, then go to iLink again. Scroll across to find iLink, where are you, iLink. So I'm reopening the app now. Okay, then I'm clicking on the little bars. It goes to BT Connect, Bluetooth Connect, which I've done. And it should find, it says you should find iLink and then connect. But I'm not picking up anything at all with this light. Try turn the light on and off again from here. On, off, on. I'll search again with the app. Well, we're definitely compared with iLink. But I cannot find this light to actually pair it. So I'm slightly confused here. The instructions aren't brilliant by any means. You know, I've got the light paired with my tablet. I've downloaded the app. So we've had the connection tone, which is exactly what we got. Then it says, go into the iLink app, click menu icon, enter the BT Connect, which is what I've done. And it says, then click iLink to connect, but there is no iLink. Nothing's coming up when I'm searching for this particular light. It's actually not coming up at all. I'm not quite sure why we're not finding it. So I think what we'll do is close the app down again. Let's close the app and we'll turn the light off. I'll turn it off at the mains as well. Let's do that. So it's all turned off completely. Turn on at the mains, the lights come on. I'm going to go back to the app. I've got, okay, it's connected to my tablet. iLink, I'm clicking on the menu bar. I'm then going to BT Connect and it's searching, and this time it's found it. So iLink app, click on that, connecting. So if you saw, I don't know if you saw what I did there, I turned everything off, including the main supply to the light. Right, so we should be connected now. So I'm gonna go for red, and we have red, obviously different colors there. Choose from, and then really you can scroll across or around any color you fancy, really, from the light perspective. Or you can use one of the presets, which I've got here, which is, so it's a pinky purple. Adjust the brightness on the app as well, so we can take that down. Okay, it's a bit of a lag actually between taking it down, put it up to full. It's almost like a delay in it going up. So we then got warm tones, which are white, which is very bright, natural light, sunlight, sunset, and candle. And you can adjust it sort of infinitely along that spectrum in terms of color temperature. But again, there is this delay in when you're doing it. And of course, you then got brightness as well in there. Okay, so we then got scenes. We have rainbow. Flowing. Not sure what it's, okay. We've got some flickering coming from the light, not sure if that's being picked up on the camera. We've got heartbeat, red. So we've got red, green, blue. Alarm, which I think was the red and blue. Flash, breathing. Feel green, sunset, and it's got the music one as well. Now music, now let's try and find something I can play quickly without hitting any sort of copyright issues really. That's always a bit tricky to be honest. So basically I can scroll through all of the music I have on my tablet. So let's try, I'm just going to randomly pick something here to be honest. Let's go with this.
I used to think that I could not go on.
So this is playing through the speaker on the light.
And life was nothing but an awful song.
And I do have volume control on the remote.
True love, I'm leaning on the everlasting arms.
I've also got previous track and next track. And then the light's obviously syncing to the music that's been played. It's great for a kids' room, to be honest, if you want music for one of your kids' rooms. It will work in a bathroom. It's almost any room at all, really. Okay, let's pause that. So, once I got it set up, there was a bit of a problem with pairing it initially. Because basically you've got to pair the light with your tablet or phone or whatever you're using. And you've then got to find, in the app, you've then got to find the device and then pair that. And once that's done, it's all set up. And to be honest, it does look it in itself, it's all a bit cheap, plasticky. Get my drift here. It actually looks really good, and they sort of like sparkle. It's got little small holes in it that create like a sparkle diamondy effect on the underneath side, obviously where the light is. So I'm actually quite pleased with this. I think it's going to go quite nicely in my house. Obviously going to have one, mainly I think this one's going to go on the landing or maybe downstairs in the hall or something. Yeah, it should be quite good. And price wise, $28.99. I actually think that's pretty good value for this. I mean, $28.99, you get the light, obviously got a built-in speaker, you get the remote control, no batteries, so you need to get some batteries for that. And it's very easy to wire in, particularly if you're using those little clips I've got, rather than having to mess around with those old-fashioned blocks where you have to wire it all in and stuff. Yeah, I think it's a pretty good light, to be honest. Hope this helped. Thanks for watching. Bye.